Hi, I'm Kurt Loder with MTV News. Nirvana leader Kurt Cobain, an extraordinarily gifted singer, songwriter, and guitarist, was found dead in Seattle on Friday morning, apparently a suicide. His body was found at a house that he owned but didn't live in anymore on Lake Washington Boulevard. He was discovered by an electrician who was doing some work on the house. He had been killed by a blast to the head from a 12-gauge shotgun, and a suicide note found nearby, according to the electrician who found him, ended with the words, "I love you, I love you, I love you." Nirvana had been struggling with fame and fortune, which came overnight with the release of their album Nevermind. And we talked to them around that time, and here's the condition the band was in at that point.
I call Nevermind the rite of passage record, where you get signed to a major label, you get an advance, and then you get a producer, and then you go to Los Angeles and you record in the studios. That's like $1,200 a day, and you come out with a big record.
The momentum and excitement at the time was so great because everyone sensed that the album was going to do pretty well. You know, there was just a feeling in the air. You know, there was just like this new thing happening, and no one could quite pinpoint it, but we knew that we were a part of it. You know.
Put that song together, it's like we look at each other and goes, God, this is kind of a Pixies ripoff, isn't it? Like we thought there's bigger hits on that record, like Lithium and In Bloom, and so we recorded Teen Spirit, and I remember Kurt put the vocals down, and then the next day I walked in the studio and Butch is like, God, you guys gotta listen to this. And he had like a rough mix of it and he just cranked it. It's like, wow, this really rocks. It was a really rocking song, really powerful.
That was the first, like, sort of big production video, like big production where we came in and they actually had built this elaborate set. It was very grand, and it was really beautiful. And there was like thousands of gallons of running water all over the place and a huge chandelier. And I remember Kurt swinging from the chandelier and he had on this like harness or something. I just remember him saying like, let me down, I'm gonna puke.
I started playing the song and all of a sudden the amp was just so overdriven. It started cutting out and it just died. And so instead of standing there going duh, I thought I'd do the sensational bass toss. I've got some pretty good air before, so I like threw it up there. And I had some beers and stuff, and maybe was a little nervous, and I caught it wrong, and it just like popped me on the head, and it just kind of fell down, and I just ran off stage. And Kurt didn't even know what happened, and I'm like walking off stage. He sees me, and he kicks me in the ass as I walk off stage, of all things. And then he didn't know what happened. After he told me, he goes, "I'm sorry, I did that. I didn't know what happened."
The winner is Nirvana. Smells Like Teen Spirit.
The winner. Nirvana!
I'd like to thank my family and our record label and our true fans.
Nirvana!
Nirvana leader Kurt Cobain, a suicide apparently at the age of 27. He leaves behind a wife, Courtney Love, a one-year-old baby daughter, Frances Bean, and one of the greatest bands in rock and roll. Our condolences to all of them. That's the news for now. We'll be back with more later here on MTV.
MTV News. You hear it first.